I've been fortunate enough to have been involved in the Picture the Poet Learning and Participation Programme over the past few months. And that's involved working with project partners, the National Portrait Gallery and the National Literacy Trust and Apples and Snakes, among others. So at each of the six partner museums, there's been an exhibition of high quality photographs of living poets and a targeted learning, participation and audience development programme.
It's a multi-texture night, isn't it? We can have it all. Does anybody here hate self-service machines in supermarkets?
Yeah.
This is for you. I got into a fight the other day in Tesco at the self-service machine. As I packed up my bags after I paid, a voice chirped rudely from behind the screen. Now take your bags. Take your bags, please! I screamed. I brought two new poets along with us tonight who I've been working with over the past 6 weeks, and you're going to absolutely love them. They're incredible. Life! It never changed, no matter how hard I tried. Some of it, I was smiling bright, but some of it, I just sat there and cried. 7 hours a day, I lived in my school, my prison. They just kept telling me, shoving down my throat, that they had a vision.
My love and I were walking together and felt so content. As our hands held one another, there was a damp muddy scent. This amazing, gigantic forest was so beautiful, but our attendance was only youthful. I was distraught, absolutely devastated when he told me the news that was sharp like a knife to my ears, that the forest was getting cut down for infinite years.
I often do gigs in galleries. There should be more gigs in galleries. It was really nice to be on after some poets who'd been involved in workshops and to hear literally their first poems, I think probably that they'd ever done in public. So, and that sort of thing adds to the nice feel of an evening usually.
On the second day, I was on the bus when there was a bang and a chorus of "Call this an apocalypse!" I felt numb. Grimsby hasn't looked this good since the Germans redecorated. On the third day, the time bridge fell into a crack in the space-time continuum. I said, well, I'll go to the foot of our stairs. But when I got home, there weren't any. On the fourth day, I popped on a Bear Grylls DVD and said, worst things happen at sea.
Because the law is not on your side, your lifestyle is not in line with legislation, and you can lose your child in a case brought against you through spite from the man that you left behind. You will have to move mountains to prove yourself more than a mother, to discredit those who say you cannot parent. You must be a pervert, you're against God, against state, a threat to national security, but you were always more than a mother. You were a superhero.
I'm really, really happy to welcome her here. She's been working with Sunderland College with performing arts students, and she's had a great time with a really fantastic group of young people, all of whom are here. Woo-hoo! They're going to be doing some ensemble pieces for you, but she's going to start off with a poem of her own. Would you please welcome to the stage, Sky Hawkins.
It's like metal cold hammers in a tumble dryer. It's like Dorothy's red shoes refusing to take her home. It's like being a raw milk bottle filled with anything but milk.
This Picture and Poet exhibition has been absolutely fantastic for bringing poetry to young people by being asked to do the workshop with them and bring them along to the gallery for them to look at. It really got them to engage, and then we discussed about what was interesting about the picture, what was interesting about what the poet was saying or what he appeared to be saying or she through the images, and that really engaged them straight away. So a perfect place to start young people writing.
I'm from the content neighbourhood beside a local school, the big white house,
an affectionate embrace,
old nice building that rots away,
from a moving home, a flamboyant, flowery, fluorescent garden,
and the games of hide and seek where I always won. The house at the bottom of the street.
Stories in the house.
Every wall clean.
The rooms full of children.
Boys and girls learning in every corner.
Pavements crumbling beneath my feet.
I'm from a bed of roses with petals like this and lip.
It's a really interesting diversity. It's nice to be in an experience that has an exhibition and some visuals on the wall that are interesting, and a kaleidoscope of different poets who you know, but seeing the picture in different contexts, but then the kind of balance of music, poetry that's been developed with people who are new to producing poetry alongside some quite established national and local poets is really, really enjoyable experience. Actually, it's been a really nice balance.
We are not mining stock. We are the redundant stock. The get on your bikes and look for work stock. We are the flavourless. The stock without pots.
I've really enjoyed the evening so far. It's been a real mix of different kinds of poetry. I think it's just great to have any event going on which celebrates the spoken word. I think it's really good for an area like Sunderland, because I think there's a perception that things like this don't happen here, and that if you do put something like this on here, people don't come to them. But if you look around, it's full, people are interested, people are engaged, and it shows that things like this are wanted, and if we put them on, people will come and we need more of them.
One of the great things about poetry, it is the maintaining of a moment that everybody else will deny was there, but you knew was there, right? If nobody else ever reads it and you wrote it, you know it happened, and it is a record for you to look back on. It's so freaking powerful.
I think maybe having my portrait in this exhibition at the National Portrait Gallery and on this particular tour kind of puts me in context. I know probably 99% of the poets that are in this exhibition, I will have read with them somewhere at some point. And it's like being amongst friends.
And I felt new muscles in my back and my chest expand with air, and further, a new air and a new spirit, and there, with not a soul around me, I unpeeled my tender fingers from that dew-drenched branch. I let the sun pour it into my eyes, and finally, after years, I let go. Why? Because I was growing wings all the time, and I can fly.
We clicked with a run, Cannes, Virginia.